All right, we're going live. Are we live?
We should be.
We're going live.
We are live.
We are live.
We are live.
We are live.
Alive.
We are live.
We are live.
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 Yeah.
Live.
So, Master, you gonna introduce us not or anything?
It's still not showing us as being alive, but I guess we started. So, yes.
No, it is.
Hello.
It is.
And welcome.
I'll be honest, it's not showing that we're live for me either. Sorry.
It is for me. So just go.
Okay. It's loading now.
It's already boxed.
Oh, okay, I'll wait till it's loaded for me to introduce it.
No, it's loaded. Everybody knows. We're up.
Okay. Can you guys, link
hello,
it
everybody.
Skype chat for me?
Yeah, I will. I got you.
All right, cool.
We are very sorry for the delays. We were attempting to get Viper into the stream, but alas, that has not worked out.
It didn't work out last time. It didn't work out this time.
We don't really know what's going on.
What will happen? This is just the beginning.
This is only the beginning.
Yeah. All endings are merely beginnings, waiting to be after it.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to our 10,000 subscriber live stream celebration. Now, for those that have not been following us on Twitter or watching the update videos and have just happened to stumble across this, this is going to be an epic show where we're going to reminisce, talk about our history, talk about our podcast, talk about basically whatever we want. There are going to be prize giveaways. There's going to be trivia questions. There is going to be an announcement a bit later on of sorts, so stay tuned for that, but we're not going to start the stream with that.
Someone told us to kill ourselves twice.
I will not do that, but I thank you.
Hey, welcome to
YouTube. Take it into consideration.
All right, let's do this.
Without further ado, yeah, who's here today? I'm Messina.
I'm Bartaran.
I'm LJ.
I'm Kahi.
Venom!
Are you kidding me?
Why?
Are you kidding me, man?
Look at Ven just sitting over there.
We can't have this. Come on.
Come on, man. You can do
what?
It. The symbiote is fully taken over now. The venom as we knew it is.
We are venom.
Yeah, we are venom.
Yeah. Yes. Okay, so I guess we should just go ahead and get into it. There's no real defined structure to this. However, what do you think about opening the stream with a Bionicle 2015 trivia prize?
That's stupid.
Oh, yeah, that sounds like a great, like...
I'm Venom.
Thanks, man.
It works!
Mardi Gras!
Mardi Gras!
Okay.
Thanks. Thanks for that.
Are you having fun?
I don't know what happened.
Okay, so it wasn't on purpose. All right. Live, everybody. This is how it works.
Yeah.
The struggles we deal with on a normal episode.
The struggles are real.
Okay, so what do you think to a Bionicle 2015 trivia prize?
Excellent idea. We should do that.
Yeah, we should probably treat the people that have been waiting for so long, right? Am I right?
Yeah, correct.
Yeah.
Here's how this is going to work. Much the same as Makuta Fest. You're just going to... Actually, this is probably going to be awful in hindsight because we can't put the chat into slow mode.
Oh, yeah, well. I was wondering that the whole time when you guys were planning this giveaway thing. I was like, how are they going to do this?
You can do it. You can do it. They did that. They froze it for, for one of the Rooster Teeth streams they had.
So they can always email their answers to me.
Well, you're implying that I know how to do that, good sir, and... To be frank, I have no clue how to do that.
They could always send their answer via email to me.
That seems like it'd be a bit convoluted. I say just roll with it, see who's first in the chat.
Okay, actually.
What we could do, since the chat's like saved, we could just like look at it after the stream and see who's first and just announce the winners afterwards. But I say let's just kind of try and eyeball it here, see who's got the first person to post the answer, and then after the stream we'll double check and make sure that person is the correct winner.
Okay. Sounds like a plan to me. LJ, you should read off our first question for the first prize, the third place prize.
I think I'll do that.
I literally, like,
with my mask.
Everyone's webcam is, like, frozen for me. It's pretty funny.
Oh, no.
Come on, you stupid thing.
I have something to say.
Oh, no.
Okay.
All right. First question.
I'm Venom!
The first question, and this is going... Where did it go? Where did it go? Oh, there we go. All right. The first question is going to be...
You can see him prepping up for it. He's waiting for you to talk. Why are people saying var? Why? I didn't do anything.
The first question, you will win this piece.
And ready? Venom!
Okay, no, not really.
We have to hurt you. Alright, so, question numero one. What was the first TTV episode to be uploaded to the channel?
Yep.
I can't find my hat.
I don't even know this one. It was like... I've got an idea of which one it was, but I'm not exactly positive.
Yeah.
I'm the one who uploaded it to the channel.
Yeah, actually, pretty
cool. Was I the one? Yeah, I guess I was the one. No, maybe you were the one. I can't remember who was the one.
Somebody,
I think it was you.
Maybe.
Maybe. I wish I could help you guys choose the winner, but I don't know the answer.
Yeah, it's okay.
We'll be fine. I know the answer.
It seems like the chat's moving slow enough to get a good idea of that.
Yeah.
It's gotten a lot more.
So... You guys like my tone?
Wow, a lot of
people really close. Vince, stop destroying your tongue.
No, I do what I want.
The symbiote's rebelling quite strong this episode, huh?
There's a lot of interesting answers here. A lot of episode numbers. A lot of specials that we did.
Is the answer a number or is it a title, episode title?
It's a number.
Bionicle. Wait, did we?
Huh?
Did you see the answer?
I think I did, but I don't know. I forgot what the answer is.
It is my belief that based upon what I'm reading, I've been letting everyone answer and I've been keeping an eye on the chat to make sure. It is my belief that Takua the Chronicler won. Way up there. He was one of the very first answers with episode 24, which is the correct answer. Okay. Thorner acts forever alone in Europe. Now we're going to double check after this is over. But I do believe you won, Takua the Chronicler.
Comments disappear?
It's hard to breathe in. Hard to breathe. It's hard to breathe in that.
This is why I don't wear
it's hard to breathe. It's hard to breathe in that mask, Elder.
I can't, you know, I guess like living under a tinfoil hat is the price you have to pay for privacy.
Okay, listen here, pal. I was right. It's going to happen.
Guys, let's not start this. I like it when mommy and daddy fight.
Quiet.
Stop yelling at me! All you ever do is yell!
Okay, so back on topic. Congrats to Quith the Chronicler. We're going to double check afterwards, but I do believe you won the gunmetal Liwa axe piece from BIONICLE 2015.
Yeah.
Wait, I have my own question.
Representing the mod squad, am I right?
That's not the same Chronicler. Wrong Chronicler. What's your question?
No.
All right, prepare yourselves. I don't even think you guys know the answer to this question. My question is, what is this guy's name?
Galador.
You gave it away!
You gave it away, dude!
You idiot! You
weren't supposed to. Why?
How would you do that?
Hey, you said, I bet you guys don't even know the answer. I knew the answer.
So we gave away our first prize for now. What do we want to talk about?
Well, you know, I think that I'd like to start the stream off on a good note, talking about our 10,000 subscriber achievement.
And I'll be right back. I need to make hot dogs.
Oh, I guess Vin doesn't want to talk about our kind fans.
Okay, fine. Yeah, Jared, anyway.
I must have crushed his spirits by answering his question.
Yeah, I think you killed his mood, man.
You killed him.
Oh, well. Rip in peace, Vin. He'll be back eventually. Dude, but no, I think as this is a 10...
Like, I want to point out there's 236 people watching right now, and I think that's actually larger than Makuta Fest was this summer.
Wow.
This is all the people that showed up and then realized we weren't doing anything and still stuck around.
Yeah. But we got that 10 dislike there.
Yeah. Well, I think we should start off the stream on a very proper note, because this is a 10,000 subscriber celebration after all, and I think we would be remiss if we didn't open by talking about that and how grateful we are to all of you for making that a reality.
My fan is so.
We started this channel. When did we like actually start using this channel? It was.
We didn't start using YouTube until we I don't know, like, seriously, until after...
BioCraft, right?
Yeah. BioCraft was the first thing we ever put up, and that's when we started going serious about YouTube. As far as that
goes, using it regularly until early 2012. BioCraft was in summer 2011, so it has been around 4 years, I'd say. Three. My bad. 3 years on YouTube, and we're already at 10,000 subscribers. That's very nice, considering a lot of those years we didn't really achieve popularity, and these recent 2 years we've achieved a huge boost. Aww.
What?
Your what dinner looks spectacular, man.
Doesn't it? It looks so enticing.
Hey, all right, back to the 2 years that we've received a boost.
Yeah. God, you were saying something.
All right.
No, I was saying there was 1 year that we didn't do anything at all. That was the void of podcasts. Like, it was like, what was it, Var? One episode is on, April of 2011, and everyone's like, April 2012?
Oh, yeah, well, yeah, BioCraft completely killed the podcast for a while there. There's a lot to say about BioCraft, honestly.
Yeah.
There really is.
Yeah. I'm not sure if we want to move into that just yet, though.
Not yet.
What are you talking about?
We're going to hold off.
Yeah, we'll tease you guys a little bit. But there was like a big strong dip in our like activity where we only worked on BioCraft like religiously, and then like the rest of the channel is completely empty. And I think we didn't really see a resurgence afterwards until I started the first episode of Autopsy, I think. And then we had recap reviews and eBay Today and all that stuff at the same time, and Invictus Analysis. That's when our new show started popping up, and that's when we started like kind of embracing the YouTube side of things.
Yeah.
Because before, YouTube was kind of like just a thing where we were just kind of putting stuff. Because before, we had like a stream that we had all of our podcast episodes on, and that was going on iTunes and stuff. So YouTube wasn't that big of a deal to us. We kind of just, it was just an extra place to upload things. But then we moved there as our main source instead. Because before, we were always like on BZ Power and stuff.
Yeah, here's what happened, is that beforehand we used to have a service called, like, Podomatic, I believe.
Oh, yeah.
Something like that. Something that would host podcasts. We used to pay for a service. About it. Yeah, it cost us money. It was like $10. Back then we had, like, maybe 3 people that heard our podcast. So
we did not get ad revenue.
To the point where we were just like, yeah, no ad revenue, nothing. We just said, okay, let's stop. Well, you know, where the service is canceled, we can't afford to do the podcast anymore. So Meso, for a while, just uploaded our podcast to Brickshelf. He uploaded the MP3s to Brickshelf, then he would link them to BZP.
I never uploaded the
until it was some other kind of deal.
I don't think
but,
he's trying to tell our history.
Yeah. I'm getting there. We discovered this thing called Rebrick. Rebrick was the big deal because on BZ Power back then, they used to have a rule that said you cannot link to any other sites that haven't been approved by BZ Power. And if it wasn't a LEGO site, couldn't be linked to. So we thought about hosting YouTube before, but we couldn't do it until Rebrick came along. And we were able to submit YouTube links to Rebrick, and because it was on LEGO.com, we were able to post down on BZ Power. And that's where we started doing stuff on YouTube, and that's eventually what led to everything, all our podcasts and everything being uploaded there as well.
Indubitably.
Quite right. So, really what the overwhelming thing I want to tell y'all you guys as a result of this is that over the last 2 years, I'd say, we've really achieved YouTube, I guess, notoriety, not really fame. We're not YouTube famous. Yes, but we've been growing in the Bionicle community. Quite frankly, I'm amazed at how fast we've grown. And words cannot describe the amount of appreciation we have for all of you in the Bionicle community that have decided to grace us with your viewership over these years. You could watch other people, but you chose us. And that means a lot. Special shout-outs. To our really dedicated fan base on the TTV message boards. You guys are outstanding as well.
Oh, yeah, thank you to everyone on the message boards. You are... I don't like to pick favorites because I feel like that's not a good way to raise your children, but the rest of you guys need to pick up the pace. You all suck. The message boards guys are the best.
Well, okay. Most of the message board guys are the best. There are small, select few people that are... I will find you.
By which he means the people that don't like him.
Now, hey, there's a lot of people that don't like me. There have been a lot of people that you don't like.
Put two and two together.
Here, let me very quickly address a couple of things in the comments. Okay, one, why didn't I put the stinking 2004 and 2005 years in the golden years? Because the majority of the fan base does not consider them golden years. So stop whining about it. Two, I'm not going to take off my mask. That comes next year. Three! don't kill people.
He wonders why people don't like him.
Taking off my mask. Don't do it. We cannot be held accountable for our fans.
Yes.
I think I've
started. Back to appreciation. Yeah, you guys are absolutely wonderful.
To let us know that we suck because we didn't add his bio to our website.
Very sorry, Takuma. We wanted you to write it.
Yeah, Takuma, you're supposed to write it. We asked you to write it. You need to write it first, and then we'll add it.
Takuma, you need to write about cannibalism. It's your destiny.
So I feel like I may have accidentally sparked some Tahu X Kopaka shipping in the chat room.
Great.
I think that's been overshadowed by the amount of people debating whether or not they like me or not.
You shouldn't, but what happens when they start wearing each other's clothing? Okay, I'm done. Sorry.
What just happened?
I don't
know. You know something I'm thankful for? Thanksgiving. Well, that's not today. So instead, I'll give you something else I am grateful for.
No.
I am grateful for the Splinter community and our fans that actually still want eBay Today back.
Uh-oh.
And I have this message for you.
Oh, no.
It's there not no coming back.
How could you? How could but, you?
You know what is coming back? Not eBay Today. No, but I do have one serious message for all of you people. Okay. Hold on.
He's getting emotional.
No, I had this horrible thought. But I'm going to save that for afterwards. You people.
What does that even mean?
I'm worried. You don't want to know.
Oh, no.
To you guys, I'm glad you guys enjoyed that little show that I did. And that you all miss it so much, even though there's only been, like, however many episodes. And,
okay.
Yeah, I'm grateful that you guys miss it so much and that you're keeping it alive on the message boards. And what else?
Not grateful enough to bring it back.
Yeah, no. What else do I have to be grateful for? Oh,
party hard.
Yeah, I agree. Party hard.
Wow. Vin, we have a comment. I want the Mario game playback. Will you deliver?
Oh, yeah, that's right. All the
Let's Plays. Yeah, hey, guys, yeah.
To those of you who actually watched the Let's Plays that I made, such as Halo Friggin' Reach.
No.
And the Mario Let's Play. Yeah, you guys have good taste. And now for the bigger picture. I'm thankful for the fact that I managed to stay in this, how should I put it, sausage fest for as long as I have. Because I did not think we would make it this far. But we did. 10,000 subscribers and way more to go. And here we are. And I'm glad to be part of this group that seeks to entertain and inform and all this other bull.
All this other bull. I'm trying to be sincere. Yeah, like, honest, it's all just bull.
Wow. Well, I didn't know we mean so much to you, Ben.
I'd probably come up with better words, but I don't know what my excuse is. So you just have to deal with what I have said. Well, thank you.
Real
cheers.
Toast. Var.
Mardi Gras. Yeah.
Check Skype. That is all. Also, thank you, Venom. Thank you. That was nice.
Yeah. It's going to be pretty interesting these next couple years. I predict good things for this group.
Oh, I am so excited.
We have many plans, and none of them would be possible without your help. So.
You sound like a PBS commercial now in front of, like, you know, Wishbone or Zoom. None of this would be possible. But it's true.
It's true. You know, it's very true.
Right.
We are not planning on going anywhere anytime soon, especially with the advent of Bionicle's return.
Yeah, no.
We started
when Bionicle ended, and now that Bionicle's coming back, we're shutting down TTV. Sorry, guys. That's it. We're done.
Yep.
No, actually, no. You can't do that. You can't just go and say something that just isn't true. You just can't go and say something that make people so infuriated that they will threaten to hurt you and physically harm you. We would never do such a thing, ever. Which is why Kahi is fine.
Never.
Thank you all for listening.
We will never do such a thing. Never.
Ever.
Never fire me. Ever.
Shame
never, ever.
Like a shit.
Ever.
Yes, yes, your foreshadowing is very, very clever. Thank you, LJ.
I know.
Shaman, okay.
LJ subtlety.
I can't even give Shaman a shout-out because his post has gone up too far. Now I can't find it. So someone wanted me to give him a shout-out, and his name was Shaman, and he had a number next to it. But I can't remember the number. Thanks a lot, LJ. You killed his live stream experience.
I'm sorry. Aww. I didn't mean it. I. Sometimes it happens.
We should have a discussion about something, guys.
Okay. Hey, let's go to Ask the Podcast.
The podcast. Let's pick a proper. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Let's do Ask the Podcast.
Podcast mode. Okay, guys.
All right. Let's go to we have a topic called Ask the Podcast on our message boards, and in there we have members ask questions they want to be answered specifically on the podcast. So not like yes or no questions or stuff that you know you just want answered in text, but specifically like discussion questions for us to do on the podcast. Let me see. What's a good one? There are a lot of like reboot versus continuation questions, which I'm gonna skip because All right. Is there an underrated LEGO series you want to see eventually return? Example: Knight's Kingdom, Exoforce, or other.
Closest thing probably Exoforce, but to be fairly honest, I don't think there are really that many LEGO themes that held my interest or really were that captivating personally that I would want to bring them back. Bionicle is probably the only exception. So,
bring back Galador.
I would agree with Exoforce. I was a huge fan of Exoforce, so
bring back Galador.
Personally,
Galador.
One story based series that I actually really followed, and they kind of canceled without a lot of push to it was Knight's Kingdom. Like the actual Knight, not the actual Knight's Kingdom. Like the 2005-2006-esque Knight's Kingdom, you know? That had the storyline and all the knights and, like, all these comics and books and stuff. I really enjoyed that. And one LEGO line I've also enjoyed is Johnny Thunder. As a kid, I loved Johnny Thunder sets. So, they haven't done Adventures in a while. I kind of wish they'd bring back Johnny Thunder.
I want LEGO Dinosaurs to come back.
Ah, dude. Dino Attack.
No, not Dino Attack, but I would like to see that come back as well. Talking about this morning, LEGO Dinosaurs, what are you doing?
Golly, caring Tahu is so perfect. Master, do you have anything you'd like to bring back?
I think Galador was pretty grand. It should come back.
I think Bionicle should come back. Oh, wait.
Serious answer. All right. I just thought of something. Hero Factor needs to come back.
Oh, okay, no.
It needs to make its triumphant return.
Oh, my. No. You know.
Hero Factory was top tier. Masterful storytelling, expert level customization, excellent TV shows made by a consistent group of animators. Only one.
Going backwards. Going back in time. Back in
time. What about LEGO Avatar, The Last Airbender? Because I used to have those, and those kind of sucked. But it would be great to see what they would do with, like, Legend of Korra.
Very true. They could do another better wave of Avatar.
Kahi, I don't think you need to be worrying about them bringing back LEGO Avatar. As far as actually bringing back Avatar. That is so over.
That's
after this
true.
Season.
That is very okay, let's see. Do you want to do another question?
Sure, let's do it. Let's go.
What Bionicle characters / creatures that we only saw in story would you have liked to see as sets?
None.
What Bionicle character or creature that we saw in the story would we like to see as sets? Mm-hmm.
Let me get all the generic answers out of the way. The last four Toahaga, Helrix, Artaka, and Lariska.
Gold skinned being.
Oh, God,
dang it. I would Lariska. Say the the Matanui robot and the other Matanui robot.
I always wanted the Morbuznak to have been a set.
Honestly, I'd like Titan-sized Element Lords. I think that would be cool to build. That will have a lot of, like...
If I could go back... If I could go back in time, and if I could get one Bionicle set made, I would want it to be a UCS system brick-based Matanui robot. Kind of like what Var said.
Matanui robot.
That's it.
System-based, really? You want system-based? That's an interesting choice.
I do not think a Matanui robot could really be done within the constraints of construction.
Well, I mean, I would assume that they would do new parts for it.
One would hope, yeah.
I mean, this is just a hypothetical question, so hypothetically we could treat it as if these are the first sets that we'd be getting for the new wave of Bionicle, for example. And hypothetically, they would put a lot of resources into making some new builds, right? So, like, let's say, hypothetically speaking, we got some, like, new torso pieces or something. I think it could work.
It could. It could.
Yeah, you're right.
Mm-hmm.
What else? I would have liked, as someone mentioned in the chat, a non-mutated Karzani.
That would have been
cool. Yeah, I like that mask he had. That's a really creepy, eerie mask.
That would have been amazing.
Fantastic to have.
Something else I mentioned, the Batera.
The Batera would have been kind of cool to see. Let's see. I honestly do really want to see Luriska, because I think that's an interesting build. She has, like, a robotic arm and, like, you know, that kind of thing. So I'd like to do just see some of that. And maybe I'm trying to think of anything else I can think of that would be a great... Tuyet and Udiki and like both of those Toa in their old, you know, in their old forms before they got horrifically mutated.
I want the Makuta and Matanui stones as sets right now.
Okay. All right. One last question. All right. Sound good?
Okay.
Yep.
All right. I never think I would ask your opinions on a Bionicle video game for new sets. This is by Black Iron Alchemist, by the way. I should probably have said the names for the other people. My bad. Black Iron Alchemist is asking this. Before anyone says, he's referring to a game released on consoles like the PS4 and the Wii U. He leaves the Xbox One out for some reason, but okay. What kind of game would you like to see released on consoles? He says he wants a Bionicle fighter game, personally. He wants like something similar to the Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi series.
Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi.
Thank you.
That would be awesome.
But what do you guys want to see out of a console game for Bionicle?
Probably something Skyrim-esque would have been very nice. For Bionicle.
Skyrim is kind of default, yeah.
Skyrim, definitely. I kind of think something along those lines would be great. They do have that Skyrim mod that's being worked on right now, so that's pretty cool. So you kind of get a taste of that.
Something like Skyrim, but in third person, and maybe off to the shoulder, like in the Arkham games.
Right. Like it's over the shoulder, kind of a... Okay. I think that would work pretty well. That kind of game is the best to explore Bionicle's world in, because I think that's a really big component of what Bionicle is and like what they do as a franchise, that they have this world you can go out and explore. And I don't think any other genre of game could really do that as well. Like, we saw Bionicle Heroes, which is a first-person shooter.
First-person
shooter on the DS, third-person shooter on other consoles.
Right. There we go. That's correct. The
I only played the DS version, though. Sorry.
That's because...
No, like, shooters don't really fit Bionicle. Not in the way that we want it to, I guess. Same thing goes for, like, I don't know, a fighting game. I think that would only be okay. I like the fan games that come out, you know, that one Bionicle fighter. That's pretty cool. But I wouldn't want Lego to devote their time to building a Bionicle fighter.
They could be an adventure. So tall. Look at him. Sorry.
Oh, you continue your discussion.
Yeah, I know. I got distracted.
Yeah. Is there anything else you guys want to see?
Getting distracted by the set.
What do you think the mobile... Because they are developing a mobile app, I guess. They didn't really say game. I mean, it's a game.
See, I don't know about games, though, because... I've never really thought any of the Bionicle games are all that strong, aside from Minog. So unless we were getting something that was really like big in depth and world exploring, I don't think I would really enjoy it too much. So I would prefer that they...
For the mobile game, I prefer for it to just be an Okoto online game. Personally.
Yeah, I feel like if they would do a mobile game, I would like something like Minog, because I could see that being done on a mobile platform. You know, all you do is tap on the screen to go in whatever direction, et cetera,
et cetera. Nice, yeah.
And another way that I could see them doing it is similar to, what was that, that Halo game, Spartan Assault, where you're playing as a toe and you're just blasting away.
Spartan Assault is more live, but, like, wasn't Vanog a little bit, like, very loosely, but kind of tied to that concept where you're, like, overlooking a third-person view, you know, and you could go and use a toe of that way?
I honestly don't remember because I haven't played Vanog in a long time.
Shout out to Bricky13, am I right?
Yeah, I was going to say, shout out to Kamen Rider Kiva, I believe, who is a...
Shout out to everyone, because this is not just about us, it's about all of you.
Shout out to Venom!
All right.
Bring back on eBay today.
I honestly do think that I'm kind of disappointed, but I think what they're gonna do is like an endless runner, like Temple Run, basically, or like one of them is like a reskin version of a popular game, probably an endless runner. Where like the toe is running, swipe left and swipe right, you know, that kind of thing. Swipe up to jump. I really hope it is Minog, because the Bionicle team. They were very aware of Minog and its influence in the Bionicle community. They had done their research about that. And I'd love it to be that, but I can also get why it's probably not the best idea for a mobile app for kids.
Oh.
Or it might not be a good investment for them, as much as it would be a good story thing for us, and I'd love it. I'd wholeheartedly love it.
I got it. I figured it out right now. This is what they're going to do for a mobile game.
Okay.
Flappy Toa.
That sounds disgusting.
Evan Miracle and Gorax, you guys get a shout out as well.
All right, we can't shout out everyone. Okay, no one from this point on gets a shout out.
Okay. We're all losers. We're not going to turn this into RTX.
Single one of you.
Fine.
On RTX, the Achievement Hunter panel, everybody want
to shout out to the three virtues.
Can you give me a shout out? Just, you know, why?
Oh, wait, can we give Takuma a shout-out at least, please?
No, okay, we will give Takuma a shout-out.
Shout-out to Takuma!
Takuma works for us. We can't just shout-out people that work for us.
Yeah, we can. We should shout totally shout-out people
that work for us. Couldn't make it.
Ouch. Ouch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I said it.
All right, then. So, where should we move our conversation on to now?
Do you want to do the little story we have?
I was hoping we would get to that at some point.
What little story? What story are we discussing here?
The Tales of New York Comic Con. And
what?
Ship of
you guys had every opportunity to talk about that on a podcast, which you guys could have released at any possible opportunity before or after we had this.
Well,
we already talked about it. We're doing it.
Yeah,
we already did. Here, how about this? Tell the stories, don't let Takahi talk. Otherwise, we're going to go into 3 hours.
Oh, God, no. This time, please don't let Kahi talk.
This is my story, man.
Adam and I stand opposed to Kahi speaking.
God, stop fighting!
You guys are just jealous because we got to go to the release party of Bionicle and you didn't.
No, you know what, Beastie?
I'm not jealous of those gigantic gums of yours.
Oh my God!
Oh, wow, shots fired.
Whoa!
That's racist, man. You can't say that on air.
Jeez, man, you're going all out right there. Man, someone wants to start a fight.
Fight me, bro.
Yeah. We got Venom and LJ, bro. Come on.
Here.
Go. So is Messel, like, dead? Because in my on my screen, he's frozen, and he hasn't said a word in a while. Yeah, he's dead.
I think he's contemplating life.
Here we mourn the loss of our good friend, the Knack. Will the Knack be back? Tune in next time to find out.
Messo dies live on air.
All right, well, since Messo's not here to talk about our New Jersey stuff, I guess it's just going to be me and Kai.
Okay.
How should we even start this off? Because we haven't talked about this on air before. Yeah,
We have not, okay? And we need... All right, we need to preface this by saying how we got to New York in the first place. You took a plane.
So, yeah, I mean, I took a plane, Messer took a train, Kahi drove. Mm-hmm. And as noobs to New York City, we figured, okay, New Jersey will be cheaper than trying to stay in New York itself, right? So the idea was I was going to fly to Newark, New Jersey, the New Jersey airport. Kahi would meet me there, and then Messo would be taking a train to Jersey Penn Station. I think it was Newark Penn Station. Yeah,
Newark Penn Station.
We would go pick him up later on. All right.
No, wait. Yeah, you're right. Never mind. Yeah, go for it.
So there were a few hiccups here and there. First of all, Kahi, you got stuck in traffic.
Okay, I did get stuck in traffic, but that really didn't delay a lot of stuff. So much. Var, okay, what happens is that Var got there first. I got stuck in traffic because I was driving. I drove all night to get to New York. Okay, so I drove up. I got caught in traffic. I got there, and I told Var to meet me at the hotel, which I thought...
I literally told you the day before, okay, make sure that you're planning for traffic because there's going to be a ton of traffic, and I don't want to sit there waiting for you for hours.
You only waited for me for, like, what, 1 hour?
I waited for you for 3 hours!
Yeah, it was not 3 hours. We waited for Mesa for 3 hours.
3 hours, dude!
It was not 3 hours, man!
Because my flight got there early, remember?
Oh, you're right. Oh. Okay.
Yeah, I literally waited there for 3 hours. But anyway.
Okay, yeah.
So Kai was stuck in traffic, so I was there by myself in a strange, unknown location filled with creepy people who want to harm me. then Mesa...
Wouldn't that be all in the south?
Wow.
Pretend that wasn't
full racist to gay, man.
Yeah.
Never go full racist.
But God, Vin, you made me lose my train of thought. Okay, train of thought. Get it? Train. Messer decided to take a train. And I don't know why he did this. It might have been something to do with, I don't know, safety or something. He doesn't trust planes or something. But he took a train, right? This train gets delayed by, like, 4 hours, 5 hours. He doesn't get there till, like, the afternoon. We were planning on meeting up early this morning, Wednesday morning, and going to the Lego store and exploring New York City. Kahi's delayed. Messo's delayed. I'm just sitting there by myself.
Okay.
My frustration.
Me and Var, we meet up finally. We meet up at a really nice hotel, which is it's really nice. I'm like, man, I can't believe that we bought this, a reservation at this place. We didn't. Turns out there was a subsidiary of the hotel. So we got driven around and we got put in a much more low-key hotel.
Yeah, the hotel we ended up staying at was kind of crappy. And it turns out our reservations, we reserved it through Expedia.com, right? Our reservations didn't actually go through or something.
Yeah, what's up with that?
I don't know, man. We got there and they were like, it says that your room that you reserved is canceled. I'm like, what does that even mean? You took my money. So that was a little annoying. We got that settled out. We got our hotel room. It was crappy. Crappy hotel.
It was okay. It's not a crappy hotel.
It was a little rinky dink, but fine.
It was a little rinky dink, but I had a TV in the middle of the section between two rooms. So
wait, real quick, Var, are you sure you didn't accidentally mute Maso?
I don't think I did. No, he should. Yeah, he should still be unmuted. I think his mic has just stopped working.
Yeah, Maso, he's just talking and talking. I can see him talking, but there's no audio coming.
Look at him. He looks so frustrated. Everyone point, laugh at him, look at him.
Okay. Anyhow.
Back to me.
Okay. I want to explain this part. Explain about Meso first. Explain what we wanted the Meso to do first.
Dual functionality.
I swear, Meso was the most difficult person ever. He decided to take that freaking train, got there hours late, and then after that, we had to go take a trip to Walmart. Okay. We had to go
hold
to
up,
Walmart.
Hold up, hold it now. Beforehand, this is what happened. We wanted Meso to go to transfer from New York Penn Station to the airport. And from the airport, he would take a shuttle and meet us at the hotel. So we wanted to call him and tell him to do this, but his phone ran out of minutes.
Yeah, no, Meso doesn't have an actual cell phone. He uses a prepaid phone from Walmart.
And no, at least he used a prepaid phone. He didn't put any minutes into the prepaid phone.
Phone? You actually use one of those?
Yeah, I know, right? Who uses a prepaid phone? It's 2014.
That was horrible.
Anyway, he put minutes on it, but he didn't put enough minutes on it. So
no,
like
he didn't put any minutes on it. His mom asked, "Do you want to put more minutes on it?" And he's like, "No, I'll be okay."
No. He put minutes on it. He just didn't put enough. But because he had minutes on it, we were texting a little bit, and then like when it came time for us to finally meet up, like I'm with Kahi at the hotel right now. Meso is at a random train station. When it comes time, we have to go pick him up, or he has to come to us. We haven't really decided how we're going to do this yet. He's either going to come to us or we're going to pick him up. I call him. Out of minutes. He's out of minutes. So there's no way to freaking contact this.
So as soon as this happens, now this is, I want to explain this. It is my mistake, but I want to explain my thought process here.
No, okay. You screwed this up. Okay, so Meso managed to get a phone.
He got the phone. We called this while we were in the car. As soon as we lost the phone, with him, Vi's like, Meso ran out of minutes. We need to go pick him up. So we went to go pick him up. This is admittedly my mistake. But... okay. I'll try to explain it.
This is the dumbest... No. This is the dumbest thing you could have ever possibly done.
It is...
Meso was at the train
station. It is pretty... Okay.
Meso was at the train
station.
No. He is literally like, okay, guys, which train station should I be at? The Newark Penn Station or the New York Penn Station? We were like, okay, well, we're in Newark right now, so go to the Newark Penn Station. We will pick you up there. I don't know what you were thinking, Kahi, but Kahi puts in on his stupid Google Maps thing. He puts in Penn Station. He doesn't put in Newark Penn Station. He just puts Penn Station. We end up driving through the Lincoln Tunnel into Manhattan, going to the Manhattan Penn Station.
I want to say
we are not going to drive in Manhattan, and you drive right into Manhattan.
I did not want to go to Manhattan. Here's my thing. I've always thought, I've just always thought there has been one Penn Station. Only one Penn Station is in New York. And here's why. I've never actually taken a train, but if you watch any movies that take place in New York, they always talk about Penn Station. They don't call it the New York Penn Station. They're like, oh, he's going to Penn Station. You know, the ex-Magneto is at Penn Station, you know, when they get Rogue in the first X-Men movie and she's trying to get away. And it's just, I've always thought Penn Station was just one train station in New York somewhere. And it also didn't help because it's in Newark, New Jersey. That's Newark. I thought whenever Var said Newark Penn Station, he was saying New York Penn Station. Because they sounded so similar, I still think it's only one Penn Station. So whenever he's like Newark Penn Station, I'm like, oh, New York Penn Station, right. So I didn't...
It doesn't make any sense because you were literally like, I do not want to drive into Manhattan.
I know. I thought...
But why would we go to the Manhattan Penn Station?
I thought it was outside. Like, it was, like, close to Manhattan, but it wasn't, like, inside the island. It was, like, somewhere around.
I've
never been to New York before. So I just typed it Penn Station. We went there. We were in Manhattan until we were supposed to be in New Jersey, so we had to turn around and drive back up. But... back to Meso. Meso did not bring any food. So we had to go to Walmart to go get some food. Hey, right, Mesto. Well,
After driving around through Manhattan, avoiding like the crazy freaking New York drivers and like tons of honking and yelling and nearly running over a few people, we finally safely made it out of Manhattan alive.
I will say that as far as driving goes, I not hit a single person. I'm pretty proud.
Yeah, there
are
a lot of people that seem like they wanted that. They had a death wish, though. There are a lot of people that are just like running out into the street,
they,
like merging on.
I guess is just an accepted thing in New York. They just walk. They just go.
I don't think, as far as traffic goes, I don't think there's many rules in New York, but yeah. So that was interesting. But it's a couple of tourists driving through Manhattan. No big deal. We finally made it out. We get to Penn Station where Meso is at, and we have to park the car.
Right.
And.
So we find
this place to park the thing, and we ask the guy the prices, and the guy's like, did he say it was free, or that...
I said, hey, I need to pick someone up, can I just park it for free? And he said, you park 10 minutes, free. 11 minutes, $7. I'm like, all right. We park, and immediately we dash out of the car, like, go, 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 go. We ran all the way and tried to find Meso. And I ran right past him when we got into the station. He was, like, right at the side. I didn't recognize him.
Yeah. So we had to rush and get Meso so we could get the thing. And then we got him, we rushed into the car, and we were like, okay, let's go to Walmart now. Because for whatever reason, Meso needs to go to Walmart. He's got to get some minutes for his stupid prepaid phone. And we start driving to Walmart. And okay, this is when things really start to get bad. Because as we're driving, we notice every time we brake, Tommy's car makes this really loud rumbling sound. We're not sure what it is.
Unrelated. This is unrelated to what actually happens. It just started happening too. I'd driven for about, I'd say about 20 hours from my house all the way to New York. And no problems with the brakes. Suddenly, just now, it's the brakes start making this noise.
Yeah, they start making this noise, and then we get to red light. We go, and we're like, whoa, the car is like shaking, doing some weird things, but it's okay. We kept going. We felt like, okay, maybe we were just in a pothole or something.
Right.
It's all
right.
So we keep going down. Still some rumbling every time we hit our brakes. We get to this one intersection right under a bridge. Red light. Okay, so we stop. Green light. The car just like collapses.
The car just fall apart. The rear tire locks up.
Yeah, it's
the rear
locked.
Right tire. And it locks up, so all the tires are spinning and isn't going anywhere. Turns out it's because on our way when we hit a pothole on our way over, and because of the way the brakes were, where the brakes were, it hit the brake control. Piece. There's like a piece that controls the brake in the back. It hits the brake, and once that is gone, the back part no longer, like the rear tire no longer works. It's just like turning around and screeching. It won't go. So now we are stuck in the middle section in Jersey on our way to Walmart.
Yeah, the car is locked right at an intersection under a bridge. And we didn't go to Walmart. We have all of our bags in Kai's car. The freaking hotel is like miles away. And it's starting to turn dark too. And we're like, okay, well, we need to get to our hotel before it's like dark out. We were stuck there for a few hours with cars would like honk at us and yell at us. Oh man, that was a disaster. That was just the worst. I could just feel
the
anger and rage of all the New Jerseyans driving by us.
I could feel my anger and rage, and my car has freaking come to a stop in the middle of freaking New Jersey. So, wait for a while after call a tow truck. Then we split up. You guys take your luggage and you start going to the hotel.
Yeah, because like
go to the train station.
Yeah, because you were like trying to get a tow truck or whatever. Me and Master are like, you know what? We'll just go back to the train station. We'll take a train straight to the airport, and from then we'll get a shuttle to the hotel.
Yeah.
So we ditch Kahi. We take our stuff, and Master's like, okay, well, I need to eat something. So we're like, ah, crap. There's nowhere to eat because Oh, jeez. So we stop at a gas station to get, like, chips or something. There's, like, this little gas station, a little rinky place here. So we stop there, we go inside, we go get chips and, like, something to drink. And as we walk in, there is this, like, one dude, like, behind the counter just yelling at this other dude trying to... I don't know what they were arguing about. I don't know, but they were just yelling at each other in some other language. I had no clue what the heck they were saying. It was terrifying. I thought, like, they were getting robbed or something, or, like, I think that one dude was claiming that the other dude stole something, but these guys were going at it. We were like, so... Should we, like, leave or something? And I was like, no, if we leave, they're going to think we stole something. So we're like, no, we're committed. We're going to buy these chips. We're going to stay here, and we're going to buy these chips. Because if we don't, we're going to die. So we stay there. We wait in line as these two guys are going at it. And then the dude, like, on the other end, like, the customer guy, goes around the counter and, like, starts picking through, like, the cash register and stuff. I'm like, what is happening right now? These guys are, like, yelling at each other. This dude is, like, grabbing, like, receipts and money and stuff, speaking in a completely different language. And it looks like they're about to brawl. And we're like, okay, we got to get out of here. So thankfully there was another guy there who was just, like, who after trying to, like, split them up was just like, okay, screw this. I'm just going to take you guys, like, stuff. So we got that. We ran out.
Am I back, perchance?
Yeah, oh, hey, you are back.
How's my volume?
You're good.
Okay, cool, continue.
Yeah, oh, welcome back. So,
I was just talking about the crazy African gas station guys who were yelling at each other.
I had to look away. I was laughing so hard. I didn't want them to see me. I was like,
yeah, I was afraid if they saw you laughing that they were going to kill us. I was just like, okay, we got no stone face. We got to play this cool, man. We got to stay cool. Okay, we're going to buy these chips, and we're going to pretend like this never happened.
Yeah.
So we got the chips, and we left. We were just like, we got to get out of here, because these guys are, like, going to kill each other.
It was pretty awful.
And, yeah, so that was spectacular. As we're walking down the road to Penn Station, it's, like dark out now. At this point, the sun is completely down now. It's, like, pitch black. Walking down the streets of New Jersey, or Jersey City, I should say, and wow, that was an interesting thing. There was a little animal that popped up out of nowhere. I don't know what it was. It looked like a combination of, like, a platypus and, like, all sorts of different things. I have no clue what the heck it was, and I could not identify it, but its head was trapped in a can, and it, like, scurried past us, and it was, like, rolling around and stuff, and then it walked into traffic. I was like, this thing is about to get run over. We need to go. I don't want, like, weird animal juices on me. Messer, do you have any clue what that thing was? Because I have no clue.
I don't know. It was the weirdest thing I've ever seen.
It was like a mutant creature. And it's like New Jersey just suddenly turned into, like, a weird, like, trip or something.
It was completely absurd.
Yeah, I don't know what was going on. There was crazy people yelling at each other, odd mutant animals running across the street. Our car's broken down. People are yelling at us and honking at us. And
I was fearful for Kahi because he was sitting back there and all this crazy stuff.
All alone.
I know. Okay, so here's my part of the story, too. It's not as long as Vars and Messer was because I just sat there and watched for the guy, the tow truck.
We made it to Penn Station, by the way, and we got back to the airport.
Yeah. No, they didn't. They never made it back. They were murdered. And their ghosts now preside in the live stream, haunting us until the end of time. But, all right, so I'm in the car, and people are driving past. And one of the guys, as he's driving past, he's honking his horn, and he leans out and he yells, "Move your car!" Like, somehow, it slipped my mind that I could move my car in the intersection. I had my hazard lights on and everything, but... I guess.
Like, jeez, I wish I thought about that, huh?
Yeah, wish I'd thought about that sooner. But basically, I just went, I got the tow truck down, he dropped me off at the Newark train station, and I just boarded the train there. I boarded the bus going to the airport, and I was able to talk to some people and get to subscribe to our channel. So, thumbs up. Good market. Yeah.
Meanwhile, me and Messo are trying to navigate the airport and figure out where we're supposed to be going. And then eventually, after, like, just wandering around for a few, we finally make it to the shuttle place. And We sit there, we're waiting for the shuttle. This is like the end of the day at this point. We have completely wasted this day.
Yeah. And then you guys are at the train station.
Not the train station, the shuttle.
The shuttle, yeah, the airport. You guys, by the way, we've been gone, we separated for about several hours.
Yeah, we had no clue what happened to you, Kai.
Daylight when I left, so.
Yeah, at this point, we figured that you were dead.
We
didn't think we were ever going to see you again. You got mugged or something.
Dead too. Your cell phones died as well.
Oh, so. Yeah, dude, our phones died because we were like trying to record videos and stuff and take pictures. So, Presto has no minutes. My phone is dead, so we have no way to contact anyone. So we're just walking around aimlessly through New Jersey. Yeah. In the middle of the night.
So it was daylight when we separated. It was night right by like the time we got. It was probably 3 hours we've been separated. You guys are at the airport.
It was like 10, 11 o'clock at this point.
Yeah, but all right. So
it was like approaching midnight when we got to the shuttle area. But then I don't know. I don't remember how you got here, Kai. I think you said you took a bus. But Kai pops up at the shuttle, and Meso walks by, and he sees Kai, and he's just like, "Hey, Var, there's a dude that looks like Kai over there." It's like we were so in, we were so sure that you were dead that we just like did not believe that you would be here.
Yeah, it was just weird. We'd meet up in like the same place at the same time.
It was a little weird, but
I know. After all of that, after all of our adventures, we actually met up at the same point. So,
yeah.
And we were able to get back to the hotel, and that was pretty much the end of the
day. On the shuttle ride home, there was a group of like drunk Canadians that were like talking to us.
Oh yeah, the drunk Canadians! They were really excited about Game of Thrones being at Comic-Con.
Yeah, they were super excited about Game of Thrones.
They were pretty friendly.
They were very friendly. We got to talk about our channel and stuff. They seemed pretty cool. Of course, they were also very intoxicated. So
they're also very drunk. So, you know, hey.
Yeah, but we made it back to the hotel safe and sound, and that was the first day of our trip.
And honestly, that was the day. Like, there was more stuff that happened, but that was probably the most interesting story. If I had to say.
Yeah, mostly. I mean, outside of the New York Comic Con stuff, the last day was really uneventful because what were we going to do that day? We were going to go to see New York again, but what happened? Oh, Meso. Meso missed his train. We stayed an extra day. Yeah. Just in the hotel room. We watched Planet of the Apes, which is a good movie.
Yeah, good.
Yeah. But, hey. What?
It was an adventure. I'm amazed we were able to make it out alive. Yeah.
Indeed. We have a special guest appearance today.
Who is a special guest?
Everybody, please welcome the one, the only, the very much missed, Tuma!
No!
How could you?
Ben's webcam is just black for me.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Wow, just wow.
I see it.
Tuma!
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 The mighty Tuma!
Tuma! Tumor!
Okay. Wow.
All right.
What do you think? Do you think it's been long enough we should do another Bionicle trivia?
Yeah, it's been long enough. I think most of our fans would have fallen asleep if it were not for the efforts of Venom and I.
Yeah.
Well,
it was a great story. All right, quick poll, guys. What do you think? Worth telling or no?
Yeah, say if it was good or not. Did you like hearing the story? Also, this actually works for our scheme because I wanted one at the beginning, one in the middle, and one at the end, and we're at like the halfway mark of what I had wanted, so we're on track.
Yeah, we got one big thing to talk about after this. So
yeah. So go ahead, LJ, do the second place prize giveaway.
Okay, for the second prize, you guys are going to be receiving a skull spider, lime skull spider. Or bright green, whichever one.
Can you guys push the correct answer in chat?
Is that the question?
Yeah. Wait, what?
Can you post the correct answer in the chat so we can all keep an eye on it? It's sort of like last time. Also, Yo Ven, you can check the chat like I've been hinting you to for the entire time.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Is that the one, Nessa?
Yep.
Right. All right, guys. Or Skull Spider. A bright green Skull Spider. What was the release date for the first trailer of BioCraft Chronicles?
This is such a I can just look this answer up kind of question.
Yeah. Also, it looks like it's split right down the middle between worth telling or
yeah, I know.
Not.
Some of you were like, yes, it's totally worth it. I loved it. Some of you said, no, never. So it's interesting. Some people say they want Matt to animate it.
A lot of people were saying, because like, while Kahi was dragging it out like a dying animal in the middle of the road, I was drawing a bunch
Broad
of things
talk for most of it.
Handheld whiteboard. And now a lot of people want LJ Draws.
Do it. We can use more Siri.
LJ
People are saying he's not even a good artist, though.
He's not even a good artist. What you guys don't know what you're asking for.
That's that drawing.
Okay. Oh.
Yep. We already got someone. We got someone who did it.
Yep.
And we'll have to go back and look at that.
Yeah, I'm doing it right now because keep in mind we wanted the full date, not the year.
Yeah,
someone did get it. It was from I'm looking to me like T-Rex Charlie 176.
Yep.
Yeah, that's what I'm getting too.
Congratulations, T-Rex Charlie 176. You win.
Yeah.
In lime green. Actually, not lime green. It's
celebration. Huma beat up LJ.
Nope. Nope. This is why Google Hangouts is unreliable in terms of the chat and not being able to put on slow mode. It was not T-Rex Charlie.
Was it not?
I am very sorry, sir.
Is it
is actually End Films. He got it slightly above, I believe.
Boy,
at least... What? Let me see.
You still got Tuma beating up LJ, so I'm just going to continue for you.
Yeah. If you see End Films got it, let me see when exactly, what comments surrounded his.
I'm wearing my Skull Spider, guys.
Meteor, Makita Cracker. I'm not seeing any End Films.
I'll screenshot it.
Yeah, also, real quickly, to anyone who says we said that we'd be doing Bionicle questions, you're full of it. You are full of manure. We said we'd be doing TTV questions. Bionicle questions are for Makuta Fest. And this
To be fair, at the beginning of the stream, Meso did say he was ready for some Bionicle 2015 trivia.
Oh,
so
great. Thanks, Meso.
Did I?
You did, yeah. I heard that. I'm like, that's weird. Like, I guess we have some extra questions.
I will admit my mistake, but it's counterbalanced by the 10 times I said TTV trivia otherwise.
It is counterbalanced. We're supposed
it's a 9-1.
This is not anything Bionicle related. This is our 10,000th subscriber, so, you know. Makes sense it should be about us.
Well, guys.
Yeah, it's totally End Films.
Yeah.
All right.
Good job. Yeah. Congratulations, End Films. You have won a not lime green, but deceptively lime-ish shade of green Skull Spider. And to T-Rex Charlie, I'm very sorry.
I totally expect you making an animation using that Skull Spider and like me in Mortal Kombat with it. I'm expecting that from you now.
Lol.
I don't get that. I don't get it at all.
All right.
Okay. Well, what do you think, guys? Do you think that was it for now?
Yeah, we got one big thing to talk about, and then we can give another thing away after that.
Yeah, stay tuned. We still have the prize for the gold howl plus the head and the eye stalk. That's coming up near the end of the stream.
Yeah, I think it's time.
Okay.
Oh, nerds. All right.
Then are you ready? Do you have the updated one?
Venom!
Ben, I swear to God, I posted this a half hour ago, and I kept saying,
Oh, no, I have it, dude.
Oh, you have it? The updated one? Okay.
All right. Everyone, mute your mics. VAR.
You ready to play it? Okay, then. Well, guys, we have a very special surprise, I guess.
Yes. All I'm going to say is this. No matter how you feel after watching this, just remember, we value your viewership. And we thank you all for coming today. That's what I'll say.
Yep. Everyone, enjoy what we have to show you. VAR for the stream. Click on Ven, select him so everyone sees it. Everyone else, mute your mics.
He selected all right.
Go ahead, Venom.
T-minus 10 seconds.
Leeway, Mystery King of Nonsense. That's me.
All endings are merely beginnings, waiting to be born.
New Duke's Brand, the universe is real. Today, I am the answer.
Get him, Strack!
You're a Toa Lima. Prove yourself worthy of the name.
I failed you. I'm a terrible leader.
My mind! Get out of my mind!
Heroes to the core!
Don't worry. Okay. We just pulled a little bit of a joke.
Yeah. Okay.
Don't worry.
No.
Okay,
I gotta go. I can't do this.
Oh, okay, man.
Oh, this is great. Look at all these reactions.
All right. Look at these reactions.
All right, hold on. Let's get this out of the way. BIONICLE Chronicles is not canceled.
Yeah, it is.
It is,
however, officially, is. As of this point, on hiatus. Shall we elaborate?
AKA canceled. It's not coming. We're not going to be seeing it anytime soon.
AKA shut up, Venom!
No, all it's right. Down there with Winter Solstice.
Bottom line, BioCraft Chronicles, as of this very moment, is on hiatus. What this means is that we are going to put it up on a shelf for the time being until we can actually, you know, really, really make it our goal and feel really motivated to work on it. There's a lot that's gone into why we've made this decision to put it on hiatus.
Now, first of all, riddle me this. Am I being heard?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Go on. Just making sure.
Heroes to the core.
I just got sent a lovely message from a friend of mine.
Oh, okay.
She is watching the stream.
Oh, no.
Hey, shout out to that person.
That person.
He's watching the stream.
Hi! Also,
my brother just texted me and said that he's watching too, so shout out to him.
So, here's the deal, okay, everybody. What we're going to do now, after we got that nice practical joke out of the way, we are going to sit down with you all and we're going to have an honest talk about BioCraft Chronicles and what exactly has happened. Because we've hit 10,000 subscribers. It's a new milestone. We feel like we need to clear this skeleton out of our closet.
Right.
Who the chronicler says he's crying right now, so.
BioCraft has been a project of ours for as long as we've been on YouTube, actually. We've been working on it from the very start, very beginning. And it's gone through a lot of delays, and we don't usually like to talk about it too much because we don't want to get people's hopes up, which is exactly what we just did this time, so sorry about that. But
wow.
But that, we...
Can't do it. Okay.
There's a lot of reasons why we haven't mentioned BioCraft so much. And there's a lot of reasons why we have decided to put it on hiatus for right now. And when we started BioCraft, it was when we first, you know, started YouTube and started putting videos out there and stuff. And we were at a very early stage in our production lifestyle. We weren't quite acquainted with everything. We were a little in over our heads when we started. And we did finish filming the movie. That happened. We created a complete map of Mata Nui. We hired a bunch of fans from YouTube to help us out. Filming went well, and we got to the editing process, and editing slowed down a lot because BioCraft took up so much space. We recorded at the highest possible quality that we could achieve at the time, and because of that, we didn't really quite have the hardware to back up all of that. And overall, the product that we made back then, while semi-complete, wasn't quite up to our standards now. And editing took a long time, and 1 year went by, we missed our first deadline, and that kind of sucked. But we were like, you know what? No. It doesn't matter if we miss our deadlines. We're not going to put this movie out until we are satisfied with it.
Yeah.
So that's what happened. We kept working on it. We kept trying to improve it. Eventually, we looked back at it about a year or so later, and we were like, you know what? This just isn't good. We're just not satisfied with what we've achieved here. It's not good enough to put out there, especially after all the hype that we caused and stuff like that. And it was around this time where we also started to get distracted with other things as well. The podcast was brought back. BioCraft really put a damper in the channel itself. Because, like I said, around this time we started doing other shows. We did Autopsy on eBay Today, the recap reviews. We really started expanding the channel itself while working on BioCraft. And all throughout it, BioCraft took up so much time, so much space. It was honestly just a distraction. And throughout the entirety of the time, we never felt that it was a good product. We never felt that it was of the quality that it could achieve. So not only was it taking up all of our time, but it just wasn't good enough.
Yeah, because in the years since we had first filmed BioCraft, we'd not only grown as people, but we'd grown as voice actors, we had better hardware at our disposal, and, at least a while ago, not necessarily now, the Minecraft community had advanced to the point where there were a lot of mods and stuff that could have been used to make the movie better. So we just said, no, we're not going to release right. what we had before. It's an embarrassment.
Yeah, it is. And yeah, Messer put it perfectly. Like, we just weren't skilled at editing. We weren't skilled at filmmaking. Our cinematography was awful. Camera work was awful. Our hardware was especially awful. We started this using our little crappy laptops. The frame rate was bad. Minecraft itself was at a very early stage, very glitchy. Everything was laggy. Overall, it just was not good. And we decided to fix this about, I guess, halfway through the time where we were like, you know what, let's go back and refilm BioCraft.
Yeah.
And we did. We refilmed a lot of things using some extra modded stuff, and we hired ourselves a dedicated editor, and we got a lot of stuff done. But
not enough.
We didn't get enough done, and our editor kind of
broke all of our footage.
He screwed us over.
Our editor had all of our footage, and he had to leave for life issues. And because of that, we lost a lot of our footage. And he gave it to us back, but he had compressed it so much that the quality of what we had recorded was just unusable.
So now it's not even objectively awful. It's literally the video quality is awful too now. So, hey.
Yeah. We weren't happy with it before. We're definitely not happy with it now. And at this point, we had to make a tough call. We were like, okay, what can we do? We don't have the footage that we had. And of that footage, we weren't really happy with it. So what we decided was, let's change it. We decided to initiate a plan where BioCraft would no longer be a movie, but a series. And it would coincide with our other shows on air, History of BIONICLE, and everything else that we were putting out at the time, which all those things are still coming, but issue is Minecraft kind of sucks.
That's pretty much the best summarization we can have for this entire spiel. Minecraft sucks.
Minecraft sucks.
Yeah, this whole thing, this whole discussion we're having right now, this was going to go one of two different ways. One, we were going to do what we just did now. Two, we were going to say, all right, guys, here's a little bit of a sneak preview and show you like an 8-minute long video we would have made as a proof of concept for BioCraft and say, we're working on it, here's the scoop, we're going to get the job done.
Like, the entire time we've been trying to figure out what to do with BioCraft. We wanted to do it, we wanted to keep doing it, and it came up to the point where we reached 10,000 subscribers, and I was just like, okay, guys, you know what? We need to make a call. We need to figure out what we're doing. This week, we are going to cut everything. We're going to stop production on everything. No on-air, no History of BIONICLE, no anything. We are going to focus on BioCraft for this week only. We will see how much we can get done. We are going to make one video, one single episode of BioCraft, the series, and put it out there and see how far we can get. And at the end of the day, when we finally look at our final product and we see what we were able to come up with in that time frame of a week, we will decide if we think we should continue it or not. So we did that. We cut everything, and last week we tried to work on BioCraft.
And Minecraft screwed us over at every turn.
No, not just Minecraft. It really put into perspective why BioCraft is not out yet. Because during that week of time, we literally faced every issue that we faced during the entire year's worth of production for this movie. People could not be on time. There is a big discrepancy as far as time scheduling went. We couldn't really put enough time into it. People had to work. We had to go to school. And the only time that we could actually work on the film was late at night. In fact, I have killed my sleeping schedule because we were working on it all night. Yep. I think all of us are pretty bad as far as sleeping goes.
The extra hours saved my rear. I think I'd be able to get back into going. But this week was just... I had to go out early. I had to be cut off time to say, all right, guys, I'm going to bed now. And my sleep schedule was still kind of up and down. You guys worked far longer than I did. So right. I can't imagine what you guys must have...
So that was one big thing. And that was another reason why the original movie had such issues as far as production goes. People just weren't able to allocate enough time to work on it. That was a big thing. Second thing, we faced some hardware issues. Finding the proper recording and figuring out which recorder we should use, which settings we should use, all this kind of things that we just weren't quite sure what to do properly and how to conserve space, but at the same time get it out there. Because currently LJ has the best computer as far as recording goes, so he was going to film it. He was going to be the recorder. However, LJ also has little to no experience as far as actual editing goes, and he has the worst internet connection out of all of us. The only way this is going to work is he was going to have to film it, upload it, and then I would edit it, or any of the other editors. Welp, that was a big issue.
Yeah.
And really, the biggest issue of them all was Minecraft. Minecraft is just not a good platform for us to work off of. It is too unstable. It changes every month. It seems the mods stop working. Sometimes they do work. Having to install things all the time is just awful. There was just a lot of work that had to go into it, and every time we weren't sure what would last, what wouldn't, and what we could get.
Right.
For example, we relied on a camera mod, something that would do panning, zooming, tilting, all that stuff. That wasn't updated to the proper server that we had. We couldn't use that. We had to downgrade our server to use it. Yeah. Even then, trying to install everything that we needed to get that mod to work proved very difficult. And this is kind of a really important mod. We need this mod to actually film. We couldn't get it installed. Yeah. And that was just only one of the things, only one mod that we needed compared to all the mods that we had planned to use for the series.
Right.
Yeah.
I also want to, like, I want to insert here. The big deal with Minecraft is that the mod API was not done. Had the mod API been done, this would have been so much easier. The mod API was announced when we announced we were going to do BioCraft way back in 2011. That summer is when they announced that. It's when they announced we'd be doing that. And this is a company whose main job is to develop this game. And up until now, the mod API has not been out. And if I am to be completely honest, I would say that the reason why I feel, personally, that the mod API was not made is because everybody who worked at Mojang realized the moment that that mod API gets done, they are out of a job. Because there's no more need for updates to Minecraft. There's no need for animal breeding. There's no need for, you know, magic. There's no need for, like, all the stuff that they added since then, horses and, like, all the other frivolous updates. There's no need for that because the mods will take care of that. The mod community will build that. So I personally think that's why the mod API is taking so long to do, because they put that on hold for a long time, and that's kind of screwed us over when it comes to BioCraft. We cannot do BioCraft without compatible mods.
Now, I'd like to bring up something Crow was mentioning, that why didn't we just downgrade? We did. We tried. We tried everything. Yeah. We spent the entire week looking at every possible loophole or situation where we could make this work and make this happen.
Mods in general are very unstable.
The game itself is unstable.
The game is fundamentally unstable. It's not a good medium to do this in.
Now is just not the time to do this, because everything that we need to do the movie just is not there. Minecraft is not properly set up for what we envision BioCraft to be.
It's not a reliable medium.
Yeah, it's not reliable at all. And it is this reason why we have decided to table BioCraft for now. Now,
we're not developing Minecraft anymore, guys. Sorry.
Like I said, we're going to clarify that this doesn't mean we're canceling it. That was just a joke.
Yeah.
As of right now, BioCraft is, in fact, on hiatus. for now. This way, we are able to focus on what we want to do, actually get our channel running, and get our other shows, like On Air and History of Bionicle, up. Because throughout the entire time of production, as far as BioCraft goes, it has eaten up all of our time. It has eaten up all of our money. We have to pay for servers. We have to pay for the hardware that ended up like breaking, or we need to upgrade our hardware to store the footage. All that stuff costs money. And throughout it all, there's just other ways that we could be spending our time, and we don't think BioCraft is worth it at this point in time. When with the new Bionicle coming out, with all our series that we want to do, with all the things that we want to do for the channel, it is in our best interest to stop BioCraft for now and do what we want for the channel.
Correct.
And when the time comes where we feel that Minecraft is at a point where we can actually get some stuff done on BioCraft...
in a stable way.
We will work on BioCraft, but as of right now, we're not going to work on it.
Right.
Yeah.
So that way we get more content out for you guys, not have this looming over our heads, and move on to other things. But in the future, we can very possibly bring it back.
Yeah, because I still wanted to do it. It's so hard to
now,
do it.
Yeah, not all is bad news.
No, I think LJ has some good stuff to tell us. Yeah. Maybe.
All right, anybody who unsubscribed to this news, you're going to regret doing that in about now. For our subscribers and members of the message board, which I advise you join, we are announcing our Minecraft game night. We've hosted a couple of game nights before. Numerous on the Xbox, one on the PC, mostly playing Halo, Dota, even Age of Empires. But so many people have been clamoring and crying and begging for Minecraft. Whoops.
I'll just move.
Yeah.
Even though Minecraft sucks.
He's doing such a funny expression, too.
Not really sure where he was gonna go exactly, but yeah. So Minecraft game night. Now, is he back?
Oh,
no,
he dropped the black screen.
Okay, well, sorry about that, LJ. But see, there's something we haven't really announced yet, because as I mentioned, we completely overhauled BioCraft, and while we aren't going to be working on the series itself right now, we did do a lot of stuff in that interim. For example, when we decided to go back and re-record BioCraft and redo it, we decided to do a few other things as well. We completely redid our Matanui map. Now, we haven't actually shown this at all yet, ever. It has not been unveiled whatsoever. Any video with Matanui is our old map. The new map that we created is, I would say, at least 2 times bigger and way more accurate. And as such, we are going to be hosting a game night on this map.
Gosh, dang everyone... it! Okay, hold the show. No. What did you guys say? What did you say?
He's just talking about the map.
I told him I told them that we redid the map. It is now twice as large.
Okay, excellent. Yes.
And
I don't even know what happened there.
I don't either. And we are planning on hosting a game night on this map.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Let me get into details here. We are announcing keyboard. I swear, this thing's breaking. I have half a mind to snap it in half, but it's the only keyboard I have, so I won't. So anyway,
get to the point.
Okay, 2 Minecraft game nights. First one, we're going to host the Island of Matanui server. That's why you guys get to explore, roam around. You will not get to interact with blocks. It will be basically a museum, but the point will be gotten across. You can roam around, play with us, have a bunch of fun. Second one, I'm not going to get into detail yet, but the second one you'll be able to build, we'll be able to fight, we'll be able to do everything. But the first one is just to look at the map. Now, after that game night, we are going to be officially releasing the finalized version of the map for all of you to download and use.
Yes. No if we can do the movie, we're at least going to do that, because BioCraft's got no strings on it anymore.
Oh, for the love, Granola. So, we'll work out the details for the actual server later, but after that game night, you guys get the map. You guys get a ton of skins to go along with the map.
Yeah, we're releasing all the skins.
And a resource pack.
Yeah, don't we have like 100 skins for the movie, 100 plus?
We have over 100 skins, yes.
Okay.
So you guys are going to get all of that.
Different masks, so.
Yeah. Yeah. And, yeah. So resource pack with...
We don't have 100 Bionicle characters. We don't have 100 Bionicle characters. We have 100 Bionicle skins. Some of them are like Tahu with the Kalkaur, Tahu with the Miru. So just so you don't get your hopes up in terms of wanting like Helrix or Axon or something.
Yeah, exactly.
Like I stated before, we have yet to unveil this map at all in any official capacity. So this will be the first time anyone has seen it.
Yeah. So let's recap. And goodness, I'm going to laugh because I think a bunch of... Far, how many subscribers did we have when we started this live stream?
Ashley just told me that we got 9 extra subscribers. So.
Whoa!
Wow.
Well, never mind then.
Wow.
Okay, anyway. Well, if anyone unsubscribed due to our earlier trailer, sorry about that. But we're going to try and make it up, because 2 game nights, both on Minecraft, more details on that later. After the game night, the first one, the entire map, 100-plus skins, and a resource pack with textures, sounds, so forth.
And soundtrack? Yes? No?
Maybe. We'll discuss that.
Maybe. We'll talk about it.
We might be able to put the soundtrack up on iTunes. If we can figure out how to do that.
If we can, we can clear out some legal stuff. We'll do that. There's also, I believe, I want to make clear that the IP service server we're having game night is going to be on our forums exclusively. So you'd have to, it's on an exclusive forum on our forums. Exclusive subforum. What it means is that you have to log in, you have to register and log into our forums in order to see the subforum that has the IP in. So, just in case you're looking for that in the future or you want to know where it's going to be announced.
Okay. Yeah, an easier way of saying it, you actually have to be a member of the message boards in order to see the IP. So, go ahead and do that. The IP for the server will be on the message boards when we actually get everything settled out. Become a member, go to the exclusive forum. There you go.
There you go. You get to play on the Mananui map that with us that we have kept secret for so long. And you get all skins. Now, back on what Vin was talking about as far as the soundtrack goes, we do still want to make the movie. Don't misconstrue that. Like, we still want to do it. And when we do it, it'll most likely be a series, like a show rather than a movie. But we still want to do that. And because of that, we're not going to reveal all of our footage just yet. We're not going to give away. Like, I think that might be why if we do decide to give away the music, we might have to make new music, because we still want all those resources for when we actually do want to make our film.
Yeah, because like in the earlier video, you may have noticed a lot of footage that we haven't shown. I know it was a little laggy, but we do have footage for the movie. It's not like we just bummed around not doing anything. So... yeah, we still have aspirations to do it.
I do also want to make clear, we do want to make the movie. In the trailer, there were like other logos for other movies, such as BioCraft Ignition, BioCraft Destiny War, BioCraft Journey's End. Those are not happening as of yet. Like we have not. That was purely for the joke. For the joke. I threw those logos together.
Also, not one. That's, not two, not three, but zero.
I would like to take full responsibility because that trailer was my idea. If you want to hate anyone that entire thing, you can blame me.
How noble.
Good idea. I did add up stuff at the end, so if you want to blame me too, that's also part of it. But you can just mostly blame LJ. It's okay. I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
I'd recommend just blaming LJ.
It's okay.
Yeah.
So there you go. BioCraft's on hiatus, but you guys are getting the map. Good job.
Yeah.
So.
And with that said, we are officially moving all BioCraft production onto our other other shows on air. History of BIONICLE. Those are coming out. We plan to have those out soon, so stay tuned.
Correct.
We recently, in terms of what's gotten done, we recently finished recording some of the stuff for History of BIONICLE. Bar's been working very hard on that. We've got some stuff done there. On air, the script, I've got scripts, the script for the first episode done, and also recorded. We all sat down, all the TTV cast, and we were able to sit down before, Envy's in this episode, by the way. Envy had left, but he was able to be here for this episode, so he's there. And it's all recorded, and it's right now, like, in the midst of, you know, getting resources together to be animated. Once that is done, that should be coming out pretty soon. We're planning to get several episodes done before we start releasing it, but that's the status on our other projects so far, so you know that we haven't abandoned those two.
Do you believe the first episode of History of BIONICLE is...
No.
Nearing completion, actually, so...
We wrote it. We had it recorded, and I think Var has most of it edited.
Yeah, I was working on it a lot this morning. So.
Okay. Nice. All right. So.
Well. Yeah. Thank you all for sticking with us. We're sorry we played that cruel joke on you, but we couldn't resist. It had to go out with a bang.
We apologize, and we appreciate everyone who stuck with us and subscribed for BIOCraft. You guys are still going to get something from it,
and
we appreciate everything that you guys have done for us, even those of who helped with the project hands-on. Thank you, and thank you for those who do not violently hate us after we did this.
Yeah.
Yep. And, I mean, even that trailer had a bunch of new footage that we haven't shown before, so it's still some new stuff.
Yeah. There's still quite a bit of stuff, mostly animations. But...
Yeah, a little bits of glimpses of things that we have... still in the pipeline that we're just reserving for another time, so.
Yeah, so we'll make a separate video in regards to the Minecraft game night. We'll tell you, we'll give you the full scoop then. No details now, but look forward to it. Stay tuned. Thank you all very much.
Yeah, and now as a reward for your patience, the final trivia giveaway. Chivaway, if you will. Let us go.
Let's see.
All right.
Now this one's going to be very hard. I doubt anybody's going to get this one, first of all. So, amaze me.
Alrighty. This is four. In total, four pieces. The new golden how, the new head, a red axle, darn red pins, and the new eyepiece. If one of you guys can get this fully right, you will win this.
Well, I had it.
I didn't even know that we were giving them out away. Holy crap!
You're welcome.
Yep. All right, everyone.
I should mention that these parts are technically prototype.
Yeah, these are all prototype pieces. Well, yeah, for the most part. The question is: name the founding members of IBZP.
Oh.
Who were the founding members of IBZP?
That's cruel.
There are three answers. Three people.
That's cruel. I get a feeling that a lot of people will know two of them and not the third one.
Yep. It's okay, we have three backup questions.
Yeah, we do have some backup questions. I kind of like some of the other backup questions. I thought they were pretty well done, but all right, fine.
We're going to ask them anyway. They just won't be for prizes. If someone miraculously gets this one.
Alright, I'm looking at the chat. I think my chat's lagging behind, to be honest.
Watching like a hawk.
Well, yeah, they're like,
Var and SOLJ. Wow, just wow.
That's not it.
Nope. That's definitely not
someone
it.
Someone got it. But they
MT's wrong.
No one got it yet.
Yep.
A lot of
no one's listening to me is one of the first.
Someone got it!
Whoa!
Somebody got it!
I'm surprised.
Let's see.
I did not think anyone would get that third person.
Nor did I. Let me make sure who actually got it right. I think that it is Crow, is it?
Yeah, I think it was.
Okay. Yup. Crow has won the epic giveaway. Now, unfortunately, yes, Crow did it. So, congratulations, Crow. The answers were Vardaran, Starparu, and Sideswipe.
Yeah,
Sideswipe. Third member was gone forever. Now, I did see a bunch of other people got Sideswipe. One dude says Sideswipe Varpanok and Messenac.
You know, that should have been a trick question, actually. They should have said Varpanok, because I was technically going by Varpanok by then.
You're right.
Oh, really? I didn't know that. Yeah, you were Varpanok? What the heck?
No wonder you changed to Vardaran.
Varpanok.
Yeah.
I mean, I was Vardaran before, and then there was the card fad that was on BZ Power that was like red versus blue, and we decided to do Transformers-related names, so mine was like a combination of Vardaran and Scorponok, so I went by Varpanok for a while there. That's actually how Starparu got his name, because Starscream. He was just Nuparu from Route 1.
Oh!
You got Sideswipe, or Zeno. Obviously, Sideswipe.
Okay, Sideswipe is pretty, yeah.
Oh, this is my fault then.
Sideswipe. If you're out there somewhere in the world listening to this, you just netted somebody a gold how. Congratulations. So.
Yeah.
That's all our prizes.
Yeah, that's it.
Is that all?
That's all.
Okay, all right.
However, we do have 3 bonus questions. Wait, what's the other prize?
Prize is me taking off my mask. That's never going to happen.
No, LJ, it'll happen next year.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. I've been telling everyone. I will take off my mask. I will release a video where I take off my mask next year. It is going to happen, I swear it. It will happen.
You know what, guys?
Can we ask these questions anyways?
You know what, guys? We have 3 other questions. And they're all really good. And I really like them. And this stream has been plagued with a lot of issues and technical difficulties and stuff. So, you know what? I'm going to be nice. Bonus fourth prize!
No!
One more prize!
I'm actually surprised by this.
Someone just asked.
I have no idea what's going on.
Someone just asked if Vardaran's my real name.
Well.
Yes. So wait a minute. One more prize. What could we possibly be giving away? These guys have kept this secret from me. I don't even know what we're giving away at this point.
I'm just kind of winging it impromptu here. So this is going to be. Wait, I got it. Here. First of all, what's up, man?
That I'm gonna be right back.
You do that.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is going to be the last prize. There will be no more after this.
What if we gave away a big prize?
I plan on it. This is a big prize.
Oh, you do plan on it. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. This prize is purely as my gratitude for all of you showing up today and not hating us because of the BioCraft trailer.
Gonna be a ton of torsos.
Kopaka's ice shield. Both pieces.
Oh.
Complete with ice.
Nice.
Epic. Those are
pretty legit shields. They actually click together.
Yeah, they do.
Show them how it cooks together and separates.
The LEGO team demonstrated this very clearly at the BIONICLE panel. They fit in these center connectors here. They interlock, and it kind of holds itself up very nicely. So I think that it is a very nice thing to give away. Now,
our people are saying your real name is Michael Jackson.
Wow.
Wow, just 12.
Yeah.
So now we just have to decide, out of the 3 questions we have, LJ, which do you think would be fitting for this prize?
Oh dear, this is a tough one. You know, I think we're going to go with the amount of casts.
Okay.
All right, everyone. guys. Fans, not talking to you guys. I mean, all of our male audience. Going to see how well you remember the lady. No, I'm kidding. Anyway, so the question for Kopaka's ice shield is...
Oh, and this question is also dedicated to Viper, who's not here.
How many cast members...
R.I.P. Viper.
How many female cast members have we had, including Viper?
Bonus points if you can name all of them.
Ignore Kai. Yeah.
No. That was
a number.
The number thing was only if we were giving out a prize. This is just for fun. So see if you can name all of them.
Wait, well, this is for a prize.
What is the question?
How many female cast members have we had?
Oh, let's see. Now,
we already got a winner.
Actually, there's a few female cast members that we've had that haven't really lasted very long.
Correct. We are counting purely in the realm of people that were officially recognized as cast members and appeared in more than one episode, which is what constitutes a cast member.
All right.
Right.
But we already have an answer. Yes, we have an answer already.
I believe for me it's Julie Brown, personally.
Yep, that's it.
Okay, now riddle me this. Who were those female cast members?
I got it. I know. Something. It was.
I want to see what they guess. I want to see what they guess. Give it a second.
No one's gonna guess because all they told them not to. Well, people are guessing, I guess.
That's
people are guessing. Oh, like I three. Were stupid. Did not.
You have to guess. There's six of them. Okay, that's the winning answer. We already discussed the winner. Who do you guys think are all the six?
Oh, fudge. Wait. Wait, whoa,
someone
hold
said
on.
Alina, Viper, Ian.
Wait. No. Hold it, actually. Wait.
I'm confused as to what's even happening right now, guys.
Oh, no. Meso, our answer was wrong.
No, I think...
That's what I kept trying to tell you. We have female hosts that aren't really widely recognized. That's why I was telling you. Here, type in the chat who you believe our female hosts are.
Okay.
Yes! Yes, you are right, LJ. That's what I was thinking.
I counted SCOTUS.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. Wait.
Okay, no.
I counted her too.
What? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm right.
So does... Six.
It is six.
So the lady doesn't count then, right? Of K's.
No, yeah, no, LK did not count. We talked about it and we said she was only on for one episode, even though we regarded her as a host, but she just wasn't able to be on. So it's not an actual host.
Technically, wasn't she on two though? Because she was on one as an actual host and then one as an interviewee.
That doesn't count. That's
interviewee doesn't count.
So and I do gotta commend a lot of you. You really know your history. I see a lot of people guessing the correct people, including some obscure ones that don't count because they were guests. So I thank you all for your memory.
It's good.
A lot of people think that Nira is Ian's sister.
Are you kidding? That got really creepy.
Some other people say Alina, Viper, and LJ.
Well.
You
see,
there's a guy, there's someone who said, like, Alina, Viper, and Keeney.
Wow.
A lot of people thought Keeney was a girl.
You guys are awesome people.
Anyway, so, alright, Julie Brown, you won. The answer was six.
Thank you very much.
Those six were SCOTUS, Alina, Nira, Mirica, Potu, and Viper.
Who, by the way? That was dedicated to. Thank you, Viper, for existing despite your presence on the stream.
Tolerating us dudes and stuff.
So thank you, everybody, and congrats to Julie Brown, who will be receiving Kopaka's Ice Shield, just without the technic bits that actually, you know, are on the set. The shield piece. Shield pieces. You know what I mean.
Julie Brown, for the record, I'm a dude. There's a mishap with that
guy. What kind of a mishap?
That's funny, a mishap.
It could be his, like, his mom or something. Or maybe his name is actually Julie. Who knows?
Yeah.
Anyway, oh, yeah. How do these guys get the prizes, Meso?
Yes. To all of the winners on the stream, if you win, you're the winners, you need to contact me at mesonac@gmail.com and send me your shipping information, and I will ship these out post-haste.
Yeah. Also, remember, if you do not send your shipping information, there are four winners. If you don't send it, you don't get it.
Yeah. Right. Just if we had an issue like that with Makuta Fest. People never sent their addresses. So I'm like, how am I supposed to send those to you? The four winners, they were End Films, Julie Brown, Crow, and who was the first winner? The name eludes me.
Toa Charlie something, I believe.
We'll find out later. We'll listen to it back.
Oh, yeah,
it was the very first winner on the stream, but we know who you know who you are.
Yeah.
So.
All right.
That's pretty much it. We actually managed to run under 2 hours. I'm very impressed.
I'm impressed. Yeah. That story that you guys were complaining about wasn't nearly as long as it could have been.
Kai shouldn't tell stories. That's the
thing. I didn't tell the story. I told most of the story.
Like, if Kai wasn't talking, it wouldn't have been so boring. Like, Bar, you're enthusiastic.
All right, guys, are you ready for the show? After the show, here we go. Fight.
Yeah, Kai, your nose is ugly. Your face is ugly. Your hair is dumb. You look like a stereotypical Asian with absolutely no personality whatsoever. And you're dumb and you're racist. And you're stupid and ugly. And nobody likes you.
And then you call him a racist.
You really think that this is between me and you? No. If you want to go, we'll fight. We'll file headbutt.
I'm not the one that's so ugly. I'm hiding behind a cardboard mask.
My hair is on fire. You can't even see my hair.
I actually appreciate our fans enough to let them know my real name.
What did you just say?
So I'm gonna have that. I didn't forget. We really quickly.
And my project is still going on. It isn't canceled.
Oh.
Yeah. Just wait. Maybe. You know what, Kahi? I see what's gonna happen. We're gonna be at Makuta Fest next year, and you're gonna be like, "Oh, hey, everybody! Hey, we should release the first episode at Makuta Fest 2015." And then we're going to be sitting there having a stall, dragging it out so you can get your act together.
So anyway, it's
better than stalling for maybe 3 years now to get the crap done. And instead of putting out
a trailer. I added your favorite Toa, LJ. Oh, he's gone.
All right, everyone.
Before we end,
I beheaded your favorite Toa, LJ.
Someone tell me.
Hitting Kahi. It's tearing his arm off. It's tearing his legs off.
Bonus trivia question. Yeah. What was the name of our abandoned Halo machinima? Tell me.
No problem.
People are saying that I won.
I like how there's just a big conversation about my name in the chat. Who cares?
That is pretty funny. All right, guys. Break it up.
He's breaking it up, see?
These pieces are very sturdy.
Your face.
Okay, I'm trying to see if anybody can guess Winter Solstice.
You just said it!
I know, because of this delay, they're not going to hear it in time. Someone's going to guess
it. Hey, look. Juan has joined the call.
Oh, no. People got Winter Solstice. A bunch of people.
I just heard you say it.
No, there's a.
Did Meso just lag out?
Yep.
Oh, great. Everything is crumbling down at the end.
There's a delay.
Whoa!
Whoa!
Demonic neck!
What happened?
He got possessed.
He's
been possessed.
What happened?
He got remixed.
Messi, you turned into a Skrillex song there.
I'm impressed. A bunch of people. Got it. Although they've surely heard me say it by now. So. thanks to whoever did get Winter Solstice correct. And now the final question before we end. When was the last On eBay Today episode aired? I wish Ben was here to ask it, but he jumped out, I think.
This is literally a how fast can you look this information up?
Yeah. Quite right.
You know, a lot of people in the conversation, in the chat are saying, LJ, prove a point. Take off your mask. You see, a lot of people have wondered why I wear a mask. Some people have said it's because I'm so handsome it would blind them. Others said it's because I'm scarred since I was a child. There are so many reasons and so much speculation, but I'll say this. If I were to take off my mask, in comparison, I would make Kahi look so incredibly, ridiculously butt-faced that it would scar all of you for life. I don't want to be that cruel.
You suck.
You're trying way too hard, man.
Come literally, the wind could break you in half. Stop trying to boast yourself.
He's so insecure when it comes
to... Kyle, don't even talk. The wind would carry you off.
It would, but I would be able to fly on a cloud.
Oh, let's see, a bunch of dates. Let's see.
A cloud, like an iCloud, you app Lego slave.
Oh, one dude almost got it.
Are we still asking questions? Can we just end this now?
I'm just waiting for like the reply.
I don't want to talk to these people anymore. I hate them.
I'm hanging out with like Groot and Ari.
One person says the last eBay episode was aired on June 20th, 2011.
Okay, man.
I don't know about that. Oh, got a text message.
I want to send you a text message, Messel.
No, don't, please.
I'm going to do it.
See, I would like to say a lot of the people that got this are correct.
Somebody said, Ellis Green said, nobody cared who LJ was until we put on the mask, and nobody still cares.
Unfortunately, this is the one question that nobody got right. A lot of people say April 1st, and in a way they're right. That's when the actual last episode was put out. However, Vin did a bonus eBay episode on Makuta Fest Live, which was on July 20th. And July 20th was the answer. So be grateful that wasn't for a prize, or else you wouldn't have got anything.
So, all right. Can I think one last thing? All right? I opened up our channel at the beginning of this live stream to see how much subscribers we had. We had 11,270 subscribers. Now, I just now checked to see about how many subscribers we have now. We have 11,291 subscribers. We jumped up 21 subscribers since when we started this live stream.
Dude, I've already known that. Wow. I've got informants on the other side.
I was afraid we were going to lose like a ton of people because of this.
Yeah, I thank you all for putting up with our shenanigans. I said it in chat. We're all about the comedy, I thank none of you for taking it personally. And we're sorry your stuff had to go that way, but it's for the best right now.
Yep. It is. We're growing so much.
It is, to be honest.
I think it's time.
On any of them.
The text message was from Vin, by the way. He said, when's the stream ending? So evidently he's doing something, but he's not going to be able to be here.
Yeah, I think he got a phone call or something. He had to go. So, yeah.
Thank you, Vin. You're appreciated, too.
Some people are still wanting shout-outs.
Shout out to all of you. You're
shout
awesome.
Shout out to everybody who on the chat, I guess.
Guys, I really need to itch my nose, but I don't want to like touch it.
Dude, I've honestly already picked my nose without real. I forgot that I'm on a live stream. I'm always just on call when I'm talking to you guys, so I don't care. And as I was picking, I'm like, oh crap, I'm in front of people.
Think about how I feel. Look at what I have on my head. I can't scratch my head. I can't scratch my nose.
You did that to yourself,
it's so
man.
Yeah, it's like
you
it's so bad.
You did it to yourself.
Wear that mask. So put the gun in your head and say you have to wear this.
There's another reason that I've donned this Kenobi.
Nobody cared about you even after you put on the mask out there.
You gotta understand.
Okay, shout out to my sister, who apparently is also watching.
Kahi.
My brother's watching as well.
Nice.
Tahi.
Yeah?
You must understand.
How many people in real life do we know that are watching right now? Just real quick. I don't have any friends. Nesso, do you have any? No. Do you know anybody who's watching? Var, you have how many people are watching from here?
I think two.
Two?
Yeah.
All right. Well, actual shout-outs to people in real life who actually have to put up with us doing this for so long.
Yeah. Indeed.
Thank you, IRL people. You guys are the best.
Yeah. You know, having us postpone parties and yell to quiet down because you're trying to record a podcast in the background.
I just realized that I've got like a giant like death staring bunny face in the background there. I have to wonder what people have been thinking in the stream the whole time.
Demonic bunny
staring at him.
Okay, Van says for us to just say bye for him. So okay. I'm gonna translate that into Vin language. Bye, everybody. I really appreciate you being fans of on eBay today. It's never coming back. Goodbye.
I was about to say, that doesn't sound like anything like what Vin would say, but actually, you're right. That does seem pretty Vin-ish.
But, so, yeah.
Thank you, everybody. Yeah, Viper really wishes she could have been here. We tried everything. We delayed like half an hour. It just wasn't in the cards, so...
The odds were not in her favor.
Aww.
But next time.
Send your
you'll see her if you ever do that Let's Play. We release the Let's Play that we have, the Game Dev Tycoon, that has all of our faces on it in live stream fashion. So look forward to that.
Yeah. For now, thank you all to our 10,000, 11,000 technically subscribers. And, well, I think we're going to go ahead and end.
Yeah. So. I think that is a wise decision to make.
Yeah. Thank you all very much for coming, and congratulations to the winners. We will see you all for the next whatever the heck we end up doing, next video series, next live stream. So, I'm Mesenak.
I'm Vodoran.
I'm LJ.
And I'm Chahi.
And Vin is around doing stuff, and Viper has been watching the stream.
Poor Viper.
Kakuma is in the chat. Shout out to Kakuma. And X is...
X, too. He's
X is in my
ex.
He's probably with his girly friend.
Aldo, what are you doing?
His girly friend.
Well, you see, I was trying to be like... Because I was going somewhere with that mask.
I thought you were going like Doctor Strange for a second there, but then you kind of...
I'm not going to lie. My dream is for one day to LJ just have his mask accidentally, like, break and have it just fall off while he's in a live stream.
What if, LJ gets, like, his mask, like, he's in a freak accident and the mask gets, like, fused to his face, like Dr. Doom or something?
Exactly.
And he can't, like, eat or anything and his face is just deformed on the other side?
He's a cut a
hole.
So
there you go. All right. What I was trying to say earlier was... I may be the LJ you deserve, but not the LJ you need right now.
We don't need
you right
now.
You're right about that.
We don't need you right now at all. You're fired.
All right.
No, you can't do that, scrub.
I'm just going to go ahead and say that we should probably stop this now. Goodbye, everybody. Yes. Thank you for watching. I don't respect a single one of you. You all suck. Please unsubscribe now. I hate every one of you.
No, don't do that!
BioCraft is officially canceled, and we're not working on it anymore, and we lied to you about putting the server up. It's not going to be happening. You won't be able to have the map. Also, we're ending the channel. We stopped.
Yeah, we're done. We're done with the channel.
Yeah, we're canceling it. Bionicle's back. There's no reason for us to make videos anymore.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Yeah.
About
goodbye. Violence. Perfect Ninjago ending, everybody. Let's all laugh. Yeah. We are off air. Oh wait, no, we're not off air.